Alright, so the final lesson is about the interaction of certain abilities and how certain abilities work, which you already might have seen, but you haven't noticed some stuff. So, and if you, even if you have, then probably most people haven't, so it's still gonna be worthwhile to talk about it, because, I mean, people will see these videos, so... Alright, so the first lesson is time phase interaction. Put yourself a set with time phase, so I can show you something about it. Alright, so you have it? Okay, yeah, so the thing about time phase is that when time phase is active, the meter stops. Because when time phase is active, it's like there is a wall in between you and your target. Now, this only happens with your target's time phase. If somebody else activates a time phase, it doesn't act as a wall between you and your target. It only acts as a wall between you and that specific person. So, because you don't have anything like line of sight for other players, it really doesn't matter when someone else activates a time phase. However, if your target does activate a time phase, then you have the option of shielding through it and while your meter doesn't decrease. And you can do this from pretty ridiculous distances and still get like really good kills. For example, I want you to activate time phase right now. Oh, I actually released you by accident. Yeah, in Wanted that would never happen, or in Deathmatch, because, yeah. But I have to, let's do it again. Yeah, activate, but wait. I have to fill the meter first. Because if my meter is empty, and you put a time phase in between us, yeah, like, my meter is not going to fill anymore. But if it's already full, or at least at a decent high, I can get a really good kill, even by running. So let's do that. Activate time phase, please. Yeah, you see, I ran all that and it was still a silent. Because the meter barely even went down. I could have gotten a 450, in fact. I just barely didn't get a 450 there. Yeah, so wait, what were you gonna say? It can increase. No, it cannot increase. It cannot increase. The shield doesn't change anything. The only thing that the shield changes is that you can move freely inside the time phase. That is the point of the shield. So, and also, like, you know that when you're inside time phase, you see blurry? Like, it seems like a glass. Like, if you were looking through a stained glass, that effect is removed when you have the shield. So you can see perfectly. You can lock perfectly. Your lock still breaks every 3 seconds, though, because that's a property of time phase, and it works regardless of you having shield or not. But at least the other effects of time phase go away. Like, you can just run perfectly. So yeah, there are two abilities that are particularly weak against shield, and those abilities are smoke bomb and time phase. Time phase is the weakest of all, because time phase essentially allows your pursuer to run for free if they have a shield and still get a good kill. So in other words, you're giving them infinite sprint plus keeping the meter. That is just too good. That is just too good. I mean, imagine if you could run the whole game and your kills still were worth 350 points. That is insane. I mean, that is the best thing that could ever happen to you. So I'll do it here. I'll run here. Time phase, please. So yeah, for example, I ran there and it was a 450 kill. It was a perfect approach. So yeah. By the way, the meter thing, the thing that the meter doesn't drain, is a property of time phase, not of shield. So even if you don't shield, if you can just like run into them within the time phase, you'll still get your kill with whatever meter you have. So after somebody activates time phase, there is no point in walking. You should always try to run, always, because your meter cannot go down inside their time, well, inside or outside the time phase. Time phase acts as a wall, whether you're inside it or outside of it. As long as it is your target's time phase, it is a wall in between you and your target. always. So yeah, that is the first interaction I was talking about in terms of abilities. The interaction of shield and time phase. Now, let's talk about Smoke Bomb. So Smoke Bomb has a delay, and as I said, it is a reliable way to counter knives. Now, a reliable way to counter Smoke Bomb is shield, because you can always see the Smoke Bomb and only activate the shield if the Smoke Bomb comes out. If the Smoke Bomb doesn't come out, you should not activate the shield. And this is very important, because your shield has a 70 second cooldown, or at least 66 if you craft it for a cooldown, but Smoke Bomb at best has like 95 second cooldown, which means that for every shield you use, they will have to use 1.5 shields in terms of cooldowns, because Smoke Bomb's cooldown is 1.5 times the shield cooldown. And this is a way of creating advantages for yourself by making your opponent waste abilities that have more expensive cooldowns than your own. In my case, because I want to take as much advantage of this as I can, I have my shield crafted for cooldown. In deathmatch, it really isn't very important to have multiple charges, because rarely you are hit by more than one ability. So it really doesn't matter to have two charges. It does matter though to have a slight duration buff, because sometimes you want your shield to help you navigating a time phase. And if you don't have any points in duration on your shield, then it might end up too soon, and you might end up like being stunned in the time phase or something like that. But the way I have it, or the way I craft my shield, is 2 points on cooldown and 1 point on duration. So it lasts 6 seconds, and it comes back every 66 seconds. That is my shield. All right, so a Smoke Bomb. How to deal with Smoke Bomb? I want to do it random, Vanarai. I'm going to knife you a few times, and I want you to sometimes drop Smoke Bomb, and I want you to sometimes not drop it. So yeah, stay on the ground, and I'll try to always react to whatever you do. Like, I won't activate shield unless I actually see the Smoke Bomb, because you can activate the shield even at the last possible millisecond while the Smoke Bomb is exploding. So here I go. Well, that was actually a very early Smoke Bomb, so it was easy for me to see that you were going to release it. But I mean, people who often use Smoke Bomb, they time it. Like, they don't desperate themselves. They wait for the pursuer to be at the right distance before dropping it. It's not about dropping it as soon as you get knifed. That's not the point. You know they're gonna walk after you get knifed. So you can take your time and analyze what is the perfect timing to make they fall into it. So here we go. I'll do it again. So I didn't see any Smoke Bomb, thus I didn't activate shield, because I always activate it on reaction. There is no point in predicting a Smoke Bomb, because a Smoke Bomb is just low enough for you to see it. So yeah, let's do it again. Okay, so in this case I saw a time phase, and because time phase is an ability which I have trained myself to react with shield, I just naturally reacted with shield after I saw it. I didn't even know you were going to activate time phase, but I just saw it and I was like, oh shit, shield, and I activated shield. But there are some other abilities to which I don't react. For example, firecrackers. I am trained to not react to firecrackers, for the simple reason that if firecrackers already hit you, it's pointless to activate a shield. Sometimes I actually mess it up and activate the shield, but this is not most of the cases. I mean, in most of the cases, I don't react to it. Like, if I get firecrackered, I just eat it, because that is precisely the point. Shield does not work very well against firecrackers, because you cannot react to firecrackers. You have to anticipate it. What did you just do? What did you just do? So, yeah. Hacks. Yeah. All right, so let's keep doing it a few times. Here I come. All right, so there I reacted in time for the Smoke Bomb. Your Smoke Bomb was still a bit late, so there was a chance I could have gotten the kill even without the shield, but I felt I didn't want to take the risk. Like, I felt I didn't arrive early enough to be absolutely sure I was gonna get the kill. So I still prefer to use a shield there. All right, so let's do something so it is more obvious. I want you to come over here, Vanarai. And I want you to drop smoke bomb at a random time. And I'll activate the shield at the last possible second for the smoke bomb. Just drop it whenever you want. You see? So I'm not being affected by the smoke bomb. Yeah, essentially you have up to the very last millisecond before you start coughing for activating the shield. The shield itself is instantaneous against projectiles. So yeah. And this is how you should use it. And this is how Wicked Ways uses it. How Sergio uses it. How I use it. How everyone who uses shield on a regular basis uses it. Like, the only person I have seen that always wants to try to anticipate abilities, even though it's so easy to react to them, is Burning Zeus. I have told him multiple times that it's not really the best way to use shield, but I mean, to everyone their own. Everyone plays how they want, so he should play how he wants. If he believes it is more effective to him for him to not react and to actually anticipate, fine by him. He's gonna end up wasting a lot of shields, as I have honestly seen by myself, because for example I don't even have smoke bomb and he activates shield for no good reason. But yeah, that's up to him. I mean, everyone should play the game how they want to play it. I just give advice, but it's not a command, it's only a guide. You should play how you want to play. All right, that's the interaction of shield and smoke bomb. Now, let's just talk quickly, although I have said it a few times, but shield is useless against firecrackers. I mean, you can anticipate it, and if you can anticipate it, great, but that's essentially relying on the fact that you have a read on your opponent. Like, you have a read on when are they going to drop firecrackers. Now, I personally think if you already have a read on a person who uses firecrackers, instead of using shield, what you should try to use is a fiend, because a fiend is free. And you can use a different ability instead of shield. For example, yeah. Put yourself here. So yeah, I want you to be illustrative about this, Vanarai, because you already know I'm gonna do a fiend. But obviously, in a real game, you're not gonna know that, or in most cases, you're not gonna know it. You don't know if I'm going for a fiend or if I'm going for the real thing. So I want you to react normally, as if you didn't know I was doing a fiend. Okay, so here I come. I'm gonna lock you. All right, so here I come, as if I was going to kill you. So a fiend is basically this. I know she's gonna use firecrackers. So, or I have an idea that I have a read on her that she's gonna use firecrackers, because, for example, Vanarai is a regular firecracker user. So yeah, more often than not, she's gonna have firecrackers, and she doesn't know how to use any other abilities yet, apparently. So yeah. It's pretty likely that I should do a fiend most of the time. Now, another thing I could do is I could do the knife thingy, as I did before, like knifing her exactly with the timing of the firecrackers. That's gonna work as well. Let's do it that way this time. Put yourself where you were before. All right, so here I come. No. You won't do that in a normal game. In a normal game, you mostly expect me to kill a civilian before you... Or that's how firecrackers are usually used. You won't go up to me like that, because you're gonna get killed for free. Like, I mean, I wasn't mashing, but 90% of the time, you're just gonna get killed there. Unless you actually lag, as you have done a few times. But yeah. Besides, it's really beyond the point of going into your pursuer if you're using firecrackers. I mean, ideally, you have to put them between civilians. I wasn't paying attention, by the way. Oh, I'll mash. You want to see me mash? I'll show you how I'll mash with a read on you. Look at it. Look at what should happen. So that's the thing. I mean, firecrackers users don't use firecrackers like that. Not even yourself. You don't use firecrackers like that. What you always do is you do a feint and you go back and then you come back again. And you come back. Did you use him? Let me put firecrackers. Not me. No, you don't try to trick me. You try to trick everyone. I mean, that's how firecrackers are mostly used. So this is how you use it. Put yourself here. I have firecrackers right now. Put yourself here. So for example, because of time you have for using firecrackers is limited, you have to be quick about it. But it's mostly the movement is mostly like this. You go away and then you come back. You have to go back. It makes no sense to go straight in your into your pursuer. What that will do is get you killed most of the time because of lag issues. Like a lot of the time the guy will just happen to be mashing a square, and because you went right into him, yeah, of course he can run away, but that is exactly, that is the way to counter firecrackers. Now the thing is, if you go straight into him, sometimes, because you just got ahead of yourself, he's not gonna kill any civilians and he's gonna kill you instead, because you went into him. For example, let me show you, and I'll show you how I would do it. Yeah, let's do it again. Let's do it the other way. You try to firecracker me, alright? So here we go. What did you just do? Alright, here I come. Alright. I am here, behind you. Don't you see? What were you doing? Alright. Ah, oh, come on. I'm not even trying. What are you doing? Why are you running at me, stunning me? I'm waiting for you to actually hide so I can go into killing stance. I'm not actually trying. Alright, so... yeah, put yourself in this group. Or near the group. I mean, I'm trying to use this place as a testing place. Alright, so here I go. Your target has exposed you. That is a knife thing I told before. So I relock you and kill you there. You can't get away from that, so... oh well, that's you. I personally don't do it unless they're gonna kill the CV. No, but that's the thing. I just perfectly time it every time. Well, that's precisely the thing. I don't do it in such a way that they know I'm gonna use FC. I pretend like if I'm not even paying attention to them, so I can time their kill perfectly, because I know when they are going to press the square button most of the time. For example, yeah, like, here's the thing. If people know you're carrying firecrackers, as I know when I'm playing with you, I'm always going to be aware of it. Like, I always take countermeasures for firecrackers specifically. Not for time phase, not for smoke bomb, not for anything else. Because I know you only have firecrackers. So, for example, if it's you, I do fiends. But if it's someone else who uses a smoke bomb, I don't do fiends. Because they're not necessary. So, it's obviously like that. Or... no, but... yeah, but it's not about confusion. I don't think they get confused. I never get confused. I'm totally sure where you are, but I know I'm not an idiot. I mean, if I know there's a civilian in between us, I'm not just gonna press square just because. No. That's not just me. That is competitive players are like this. Of course, if your timing is good, you can get them to kill the civilian, of course. I mean, even competitive players. But you have to have good timing. You cannot just like be all obvious about it, like, oh hello, here I am trying to firecracker you. Of course not. In that case, they're always gonna know. No, I don't think you got him confused. He already knew you were gonna use firecrackers. The problem is there was a civilian in the way. And what you want him to do? What you want him to do? You want him to kill a civilian? No! We're not dumb enough to do that. I mean, for example, if I am here, if you catch me in between a group of civilians with firecrackers, I won't press square. And it's not about confusion. It's about the opposite. I'm not confused at all. I know what I'm doing. I know if I press square, I'm going to kill a civilian. So why press square? Why? It makes no sense, you see? Oh yeah, probably. Probably because that is the whole point. That is the right way to use firecrackers. You wanna trap them in between civilians. But another way of using it without making it so obvious, because that is a problem of your approach. Like, well, besides the fact you only use firecrackers and that makes it even more obvious, but as soon as I see somebody trying to, like, they already know it's me. They already know I'm their pursuer. They have given obvious signs that they know I am their pursuer. And I see them blending into groups. And they are a good player. Let's say Sergio, Wicked, anyone. Any of the good players. If I see them blend, I know they're trying to use firecrackers. I just know it. Like, even if they don't usually use firecrackers, if I see them blend after they know I'm after them, there's absolutely no reason for them to do that unless they have firecrackers or time phase. That is the only reason why people do that. Now, there is another way of using firecrackers, by the way. Of course. Yeah, of course, because, I mean, I'm not saying it is impossible to land firecrackers. Yeah, but your approach is so aggressive that I think there is a pretty easy counter to, like, to counter you. Besides fiends and that, there is an even easier way to counter an aggressive firecracker user that doesn't dissimulate their intent, because that is a problem. You don't dissimulate. I know you're trying to use firecrackers. So if people are doing it like that, an easy, really, really easy way is what I'm going to show you now. Alright, let's do it. Try to use firecrackers on me. Put yourself near groups. Here I come. Wow, you... No, the firecrackers didn't even... You stunned me before the firecrackers even came out. You didn't even hit me with firecrackers. You stunned me. You just stunned me. Plain. Well, not on my screen. Literally, you just stunned me. I mean, if I had pressed square, I would have killed you. But I didn't. All right. There you go. Hello there, Vanarai. Stay there, please. All right. Oh, thanks. Yeah, but it happens mostly because you're absolutely obvious about it. No, I don't do this much because I don't need to do it. I can already counter you even without using firecrackers, but I mean, other firecrackers users are gonna kill the shit out of you. I mean, if, for example, the thing is that it depends on who's the threat. If you're the only threat in the lobby, I could afford to do this every time. I mean, if you're the only good person in the lobby. Now, because usually you're not the only good person in the lobby. How can you stun me? Oh, well, by making it unpredictable. No, okay, I'm talking about firecrackers now. I'm not talking about other abilities. Well, honestly, I'm sorry, but that is something you still have to fix. Like, you still have to learn to play with other abilities. I'm sorry, I mean... Just the fact that you only know how to use a hammer, it really limits your opportunities as a good player. You have to learn to use the other abilities. Now, about firecrackers themselves, well, you have to vary your style. You can always be absolutely aggressive, because if you're always aggressive on the firecracker approach, you're gonna end up killing tons of civilians if they always use firecrackers. So. You could be aggressive most of the time, but you could mix it up by sometimes doing a feint, as we spoke before, like, put yourself here. Like, waiting for them to kill a civilian. Don't always go for the plain stun. I mean, sometimes also go for this, and this is, there's another reason why you should do this, and it's because you can get a focus or a half focus on them, depending on how much time they stay close to you. So, for example, I'm actually gonna... Don't use firecrackers. I'm just gonna do the movement of what I was talking about, which is the non-aggressive approach. It's kind of how I did before. Like, you do this. Like, you go back. If they go back, it's fine. I mean, okay, you use your firecrackers and you didn't land them. But in many cases, you can get them to kill a civilian. In many cases. And when they do, you have more than enough time to get close to them and get a half focus. I mean, let's do that. Now let's do it the other way. Now you're gonna do the passive approach. Of firecrackers, and I'm gonna go as if I was going to kill you, but I'll kill a civilian this time, kinda on purpose, but it actually reflects the reality of how it works. So here we go. Yeah, so I killed it, and I'm no. You have to stun me. You have to take the half focus and stun me. You cannot just let me get away. So yeah, just take like a half focus and stun me. That is the whole point of this. By the way, I cannot kill my copies. That's something many people don't know, but I cannot kill my copies. So if you use firecrackers and there's only copies of me around, I'm never gonna kill them. Never. So you have to be paying attention when you use firecrackers. Now, don't use firecrackers where your pursuer has copies. All right, so here we go. Oops. That is a problem of being aggressive about it. That is a problem. For example, in this case, my lock didn't... it was about to break, but it didn't break. So, like, you were too aggressive about it. So I killed you. This is what I was talking before. When I told you, like, that you didn't even firecracker me, that you only went straight for the stun, it's precisely what I was talking. Like, if I was actually trying to kill you there, I would have killed you. Because the firecrackers didn't even kick in properly. I barely even saw the flash, and I was already stunned. I mean, my luck didn't even break. But yeah, so that's why the passive approach is good as well sometimes. Not always, but sometimes. Because if you always do it the same way, they're gonna read you. So that is the point. You don't want to be read. Okay, here I come. Alright, there you go. Oh, you can knife me. If you knife me, you should always go for the full focus. If you knife me, always go for the full focus. Because you want to get full points redeemed for the abilities that you use. And you use two abilities. I mean, well, obviously not always, but I'm talking about desire, not about factibility. I mean, it might not be feasible because there are pursuers around. But if there are no pursuers around, if you have no pursuers at all, for example, you should always go for the focus. Always. Unless maybe, I don't know. No, actually, you cannot know how many pursuers your pursuer has. So there is no way for you to know if your target is about to, your pursuer is about to die. For your target, it is different because if your target kills a civilian, and you know that he has like 3 or 4 pursuers, then it's okay, you should actually not wait. But if your target does not have any pursuers, any other pursuers beside you, and you can manage to make them kill a civilian and knife them, you should always go for the full focus. If logical, I mean, if they drop smoke bomb, obviously you can't. You have to kill them, right? I mean, I'm just like speaking common sense here. But the thing is, you should really try to get full points for whatever abilities you use. Because remember, this game is about creating small advantages. That's all about it. And, alright, okay, get down here. I think that's pretty much everything about firecrackers. One more thing about firecrackers that most people don't know, and this is also true for time phase, is that when your lock gets, broken, you can always re-lock them after the firecracker. And this can help you get the kill after the fact. So you should always try to re-lock your person. Even while blinded, you can always know that the aim dot is at the center of your screen. And even if you get firecrackered and your lock breaks, you should try to lock them again to get the kill. Instead of just pressing a square at random. Because pressing a square at random will more often than not lead you into killing a civilian. But with time phase and firecrackers, you can always re-lock them. Alright, so one more thing about firecrackers. It works with hay bales as well. This is one way you can make your firecrackers less obvious, and it's by being around hay bales. And if you know they're like mashing, you can bait them into killing the hay bale. So, and when they do that, you can stun them. No, very rare. Well, it's very rare because you very rarely try it, but for me, it works every time, or almost every time, and it works a lot with good players. It's not hard to accomplish because it is easy to lure your pursuer into... No, you're wrong. Actually, they are that stupid if you consider that stupid. Because the problem is that it is really uncomfortable. People are... What they are not stupid enough is to jump into the hay bale. They're not gonna jump into the hay bale. They're not that stupid. But they will kill it if you drop firecrackers near the hay bale. So let's do that. For example, I want you to try to kill me now. Of course, you... No, I'm gonna do this, but I want you to press the square button at the most sensible time when you are about to kill me near the hay bale. So here we go. Well, wait, let me, don't use firecrackers. What the hell are you doing? You're the one trying to kill me. Sorry, let me release, by the way. Okay, so yeah. So here we go. Your target has try to kill. No, don't release. Don't release. You are my pursuer. Alright. So here we go. You see? It's not that hard. Oh, yeah, you would never do that because you would never even press square. You can still kill the Havo after you knife me. I mean, people, more often than not, at that distance, they start pressing square. I mean, because... okay, you'll never fall for it, right? Okay, Vanarai, the great Vanarai, will never fall for this. Yeah, she knows this trick, so she'll never fall for it. Alright, I'll just remind you when you do actually fall for it, I guess. It's no use speaking sense into you. I'll just do it with proof sometime. But yeah. I just use it when it makes sense. I mean, obviously, you cannot do it often, because if you do it often, obviously, they're gonna read you. But that is the truth for any ability, not just for firecrackers. If you always do the same thing, they're gonna read you. I mean, people are dumb, but they learn. They learn over time. They're not that dumb. So, yeah. Yeah, alright, I'll back out.